episode 2828, Live Guilt-Free.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. It's Friday, and I hope you're as excited as I am because, whoa, has it been a long week? It has been a fabulous week, but you know what? If you're a mom, you totally get it. It's like, can I just turn my name off for a moment? Can I just live without being interrupted for 1 second? Live guilt-free. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. It's very interesting, right? It's confession day, and I hope you're ready to let it all hang out and just be you for a moment. Don't worry about trying to please your children, trying to please your partner, trying to please yourself, trying to please your animals like the puppies and the kitty cats. No, I want you to take a moment and just breathe. Listen to this for just a moment. Second-guessing your decisions and conversations with your children can disrupt your confidence in parenting. That's a true statement. So give yourself grace and live guilt-free. What good does it do for you to beat yourself up over stuff you can control, but not how it's received? That's a hard question. I was asking myself that earlier today. I was like, you know what? Why is it that I sit here and I think about what I said or a conversation I had with my children, and I'm worried about what they're thinking instead of what did I say? Because remember, I can't control what they think. I only can control what I say. Parenting, honestly, it can be the pits. Let's just call it like it is. We work hard every day to have our children throw temper tantrums, backtalk us, and defy our request to do what's right. Sound like your life? Ah! Ugh, yeah. It is all too familiar, unfortunately. If only parenting was easier. Mom guilt, it's a real thing. It's real. And unfortunately, there are many of us who are living in that self-inflicted world. We overthink, we overplay, we're overwhelmed. Welcome to motherhood. I mean, isn't that the basket you want to receive after delivering your child? I mean, seriously, I'm like, yeah, and maybe like 3,000 bottles of wine to go with the rest of your life and raising the child. But I digress, and that's for another episode. Honestly, alcohol, by the way, is not the answer. And no, I do not drink. So I say that to kind of put a little bit of humor in something that's real because nobody wants to talk about this. Mom guilt is a real thing. We carry it with us all around. And I don't know if you realize that we are just a little over 2 months to the end of the year. We are now basically 2 months into the school year. So we're kind of stuck in the middle here of our season before the new year happens. We're on the brink of holiday season. I don't know about you. Did you see all those sales? I don't know what your wish list is to Santa Claus, but wouldn't it be nice if you could write off mom guilt? How cool would that be? But as you and I know, right, you can't send your child back. Right? I mean, if only we could send our children back. So you have to finish the job well. You have to parent well. You need to train up your child in a way that honors your heritage, your morals and values, and your religious beliefs. Now, as you continue to teach them daily, you instill these expectations, right? You keep raising their ceiling and increase their responsibilities, knowing what to do and how to handle themselves. Ultimately, that's what you want them to be able to do, is that when you're not around, they already know what they're supposed to do because you have said this over and over and over again. And they have this little voice in their head that says, Mom said this, and this is where I'm confident, and this is what I'm going to do. However, you also have to know you don't control everything. Your child has been given a mind. Oh, yes, you can control the environment, but you can't control their actions. I know, that's the bad news of the whole thing. However, there's still hope. Be consistent. Stay on your knees, right? Stay in contact all the time with God. I'm telling you, if it wasn't for my relationship with God, I don't know. There would have been times I probably would have literally pulled my hair out. And do what you know is best. Sometimes that means you'll be making tough decisions. That's okay. Surround yourself with wise counsel and live guilt-free. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Live guilt-free. Now, you and I both know that this doesn't come easy, so don't pretend it does. Neither, though, should you reflect so much that it drives your every step. Find the balance that stimulates healthy conversations and discipline which works for your family. Now, remember, you've got to set this up for your family. It's not about me telling you the rules. You have the rules. You know them. I'm not here to say and tell you what you need to do within your four walls. Now, I can give you tools and strategies on how to implement your rules. Now, if you want suggestions on your rules, well, that too would be for another episode. But that's not what we're talking about here. This is about saying, I know how I want my family to operate. I know how I want to raise my children. I know the environment that I want to create for them. So you lay that landscape out. You become determined by being consistent. Stay on your knees. Let God do a lot of the work. And then, most importantly, live guilt-free. And you can do this by doing three things. Okay, now, this is not going to be just like one and done. This is going to take time. And I also have to preface it with this. You will have situations that are just plain, out of the ordinary, tough, tear-wrenching, gut-wrenching, heart-pulled-out-of-your-chest type of situations. You can't plan for those. However, you can prepare for them by doing what you know is best. So what do you do to live guilt-free? What are those steps that you can control personally? Well, number one, be decisive with your directions. Whatever you are doing with your child, whether in conversation or in action, don't live in limbo. That what if scenario, right? If you're still thinking, oh my gosh, if I would have just done this, the should have, could have, would haves do not get you anywhere. It doesn't give you that badge of honor that you might be searching for quietly, right? So you have to be decisive with your directions. If you're wanting your child to go to bed at 9 o'clock, then your child needs to be in bed at 9 o'clock. Not starting to get ready for bed at 9 o'clock, but be in bed by 9 o'clock, which means that maybe your bedtime starts at 8:30 to have that whole routine. But you have got to figure out what you need and be decisive. If at all you give them leeway of, well, that 9 o'clock really means 10 o'clock. What do you think that's going to do? Well, as they get older, that 11 o'clock curfew is going to become 1 o'clock in the morning. Is that really what you want? Start young. Be decisive with your directions. Number two, be clear with your confidence. If your child thinks you at all feel uncomfortable with your discipline or how you're handling the situation, they'll sniff it out so fast, making your head spin. They'll be like, Mom has no idea. She's just full of it. I can walk right all over her. And unfortunately, those wonderful tween years that we love so dearly, going into the teenage years, what do you think's happening there? If we question what we're doing, our confidence, goes in the bucket. If your confidence is in the ditch, there's no way that your child is going to know that you're serious. You cannot let your guard down. You have to be strong in front of them always. Now, that doesn't mean that you can't show emotion, good or bad, right? If they did something wrong, let's say you caught them drinking. Do you think you're going to stand there and go, oh, babe, alcohol, it's just a bad thing, and you really shouldn't have drank half the bottle. You're not going to do that. It's a life or death situation. They chose something wrong. There's consequences. Now, you may not be in the situation to make the decision as to what you're going to have for their consequences, so you take a step back, but that doesn't mean that your confidence is less than. Just because you're not making a decision at that immediate moment doesn't mean that you don't know what you're doing. You are the parent, so be clear with your confidence. And finally, number three, be attentive with your appreciation. Let your gratitude for what is done correctly speak louder than your thoughts, words, and actions. Everyone wants to hear what they're doing right. Everyone does. I don't care if you're a little one or if you're a little big one, okay? Everybody in between, from 2 months to 102. Yeah, we're living longer, so I have to extend our age a little bit. Everything in between. Everybody wants to know that they're doing something right. So does your child. So tell them. It'll stick more. It really, truly will. Because if you sit there and are like, well, you know, you really could do something better here. And, you know, if you were just looking out in this direction, you made this decision, really? Why not say, you know what? I don't know what I would have done in your position, but what you did was exactly what needed to be done. Now, could you have changed a few things? Of course. But I just want you to know that in the heat of the moment, you did what was right, and I'm proud of you for that. Wow, let me tell you, your child is going to be listening with their head, their heart, and their mind and body. It's all gonna be all in because you're saying you did something right. Unfortunately, we tell our kids a lot of the times what they're doing wrong. They don't get that gratitude of appreciation all the time, that reinforcement. We've got to shore up that foundation so it'll stick. Now, if you can give yourself more grace rather than running a rat race, then you will make it through the pivotal years of child rearing. You just will. But you've got to be patient with yourself. This is a marathon. And I'm here to tell you, I started with little ones, and now I'm to big ones, and now I've got little ones again because we have our grandbaby. And when I look at all of that, I am going full circle. And let me tell you, it's beautiful, but it's also tough as all get out. There are times that I have to hold my tongue, and I don't want to. Imagine that, me not wanting to speak. Oh, yeah. But I need to in order for my child to learn, whether my child's an adult, a teenager, I have to hold my tongue. Sometimes I have to let my child fail. I don't like that. We don't want our children to have to go through anything bad. But in order for them to learn, in order for them to be on their miles of greatness journey, what do you think has to happen? They've got to have failures too, or they will never be able to climb the mountaintops. Our children do not need a handout. They need a hand up. And so you get to determine how you want to raise your child. But in doing so, you have to give yourself grace. Stop running that rat race. And I promise you, you're going to help raise up a generation that will impact the world. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, blessed day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.